Well, here it comes. The Jeep. With non-functioning air conditioning. Alright. He's going to pull around back. Well, that's what I told him to do. But I don't think he's doing it. But it don't matter. We'll get it back there one way or another. Alright, here we go, gang. We are in. Oh, open me up here. So, give me the symptom is hot. Let me get up in here. God, who's been sitting here? One of the munchkins or something?
Yeah, I had the seat moved up. You can move it back. I had to get one of the little chaps in here.
So the symptoms are that you don't even think that the compressor's engaging because it has a binary switch or something?
Yeah, when you turn it on. Okay.
So.
Nothing happens.
Ooh, 117. How nice.
And so, it's got to have, in order for the compressor to work, it's got to have some.
Yeah, it's a binary switch, they call it. There's a binary and a trinary switch.
Trinary.
And a trinary will, I think I'm right on this. There's a switch that will not allow the compressor to engage when the Freon is too low.
Okay.
And then there's another switch, just pull right behind the old DAF there.
All right.
And then there's the other switch will cut the compressor out if it's too low or too high.
Oh, okay. Do you want me? All right. Do you want me to leave it running? I'll pop it.
But there we are. 118 degrees. Sweet.
I'll put it on. Let's see if we get anything at all.
Okay.
I don't think we get nothing.
No, there's nothing. There's nothing there. 121.
I don't even feel the compressor running.
You can hear that. You can feel the engine change too. Okay, well, let's get to work. So this is a binary switch that's only got two wires.
Okay.
So that's the switch that's killing the compressor.
Okay.
So right now we're not engaging there.
That should be okay, right?
That's okay.
Yeah.
So there's
this is all virgin, no but you.
Messed with it.
Right. Oh, sorry. Nobody's messed with it.
Okay, now there's your two lines. Now this is a what? This is a what year?
It's a 98.
A 98.
It's a 134A.
4 liter. The old 4 liter mobile.
Okay.
And the mileage.
190.
190 something like this.
Yeah.
Well, don't put the key in it yet, because we're gonna have to crank it here in a minute anyway. So I got my gauges ready to go. And we have found most everything we need. So did it taper off or did it just die? You've been in the mud somewhere.
Oh, that's what mud daubers did.
Oh, that. Mud dauber. Okay.
It was running good all the way up until wintertime. Then I'd hardly ever used it that much. And so when it didn't taper off, I think it just, I turned it on one day and it just didn't work anymore.
Okay.
And after a period of not using it, so it could have been a slow leak over the wintertime.
Okay, that's probably what it was. So I'm going to probably make a cocktail of a little Red Devil sealant and a little bit of oil and inject it in there, and then we'll put the Freon. But we're going to check the pressures on it right here in a second. So we got to make sure everything, let's get these off. Okay, we're going to do this thing. Pull that other thing and put them right there so you won't forget them.
That's low pressure.
There's no use in cranking it because it ain't coming on anyway. Let's just see if we got anything in there. Now, never over tighten these. You just want the. You got nada, man. You got nothing.
Yeah.
Maybe we ought to pull a vacuum on it.
Yeah.
Since you got nothing.
You gotta get all the
tout
out of it. Dang air.
Dang the consarned air. You got zero, baby. Let's see if I've got Schrader's for this, since we've got no pressure at all. Because usually it's the Schrader's that cause the problem.
Because I'm going to tell you, when we charge this thing, that damn air, you almost had to wear a jacket riding around in the thing.
Well, you can control that, can't you?
Yeah, I did. But I'm just giving
it's
you an
just
idea.
Good.
That's how cold the air was on it.
Okay, well, I don't need to worry about safety glasses or nothing.
It's 95 degrees coming up.
Let's see if... This isn't like your typical Dodge where you got to get the whole flipping hose, is it?
No.
Okay, so we got all the valves open. We're going to pull a vacuum on it to see if it...
Okay.
See if we got any leaks anywhere. That one don't... Okay, we'll see about that. High side don't bother me too bad. Okay, here we go. Here's the old rubbing air. All right, it's going down.
Does that mean pull a vacuum? We're already at 20, almost, well, I don't think you got a leak, but we're going to pull a vacuum on it and get the moisture out of it and all the old stuff.
Okay.
So you're heading toward 30. Can't get to 30 on this planet, but that's okay.
You can't? So you're shooting for 28? Is that what you're saying?
Yeah.
And what does the red indicate?
That's the high side. It don't really need to be on even. We can just pull it out of the one side.
I got you. I'm just curious.
And again, you've done stuff. Done the stuff.
I tried to follow it on YouTube and I thought, oh yeah, I'm sorry.
Why is that? Every time you get that camera.
It's not every time I get the camera on, trust me. It's all the time, but it's okay. So all the muck in the air is the Canadians not managing their forest. So, anyway, we're going to let this, I'm going to set a timer on this. I don't think we're going to go real long on this. So there's the oil we're going to use. Let's see, we've got all this for fruit. We've got to get 20 ounces. So that's almost 2 cans. So that'd be 24 ounces. So we're going to make our little concoction, and there's my Freon sniffer, don't need that, and we got this thing, all right, and we got a PAG charge here, there's 46, okay, that's what it calls for, and there's that, and there's 100, there's more Freon, and there's some of that. Okay. To think about that, I think I'd rather use my injector system here and get oil in it and everything. Okay, let's make our little cocktail brew here.
I really love something cheap.
Okay, we're gonna close this valve now.
Okay.
And we're going to see. Let's close it over here,
okay.
And then we're going to let it sit for a while. It's been about 15 minutes, so we've got the high side off. We got this valve closed. We're going to leave that there, okay. And we're going to let it sit for a few minutes.
Okay.
And so when we turn this back on, it ought to show vacuum. But right now, this is why I do it this way, because this whole system has a little bit of leaks in it. So in here, some Ester.
Yeah.
And a PAG 46,
yeah.
And some Red Devil stop leak.
Gotcha.
And it's about an ounce, so we're going to go for 19 ounces or so of coolant. So what we're going to do is we're going to turn the air conditioner on,
yeah.
And start the motor and everything, and then we're going to put Freon in it and see if the clutch kicks in. And if that happens, you should start feeling it getting pretty instantly cool.
Gotcha. Anyway, he grabs her and pulls her off because she's screaming and slapping her leg out, and he's yanking her pants off down to her daggum underwear, and he's trying to get all of them. He says, "You just got in a bunch of these we call fire ants, blah, blah, blah." And I was like, I'll never forget that.
The first time I got bit by one, I was working on mix convertible Buick at WIS in Columbia,
yeah.
In the parking lot. He said, "Be careful, there's a thing called fire ants." I said, "Okay." And about a minute later, I understood what that was. It got me right in the ankle. That's the first time I'd ever seen them. Okay, let's see if we got a vacuum here. Watch that gauge up there.
Okay, what do you want me to...
Just tell me if it goes down.
Yeah, it goes down. Went down to about 28.
All right, so that's pretty good. Okay, that's pretty good. Okay, so that's what we want. So we're going to... We're gonna bleed this off now. And... Okay, well, it does hold. That's good. I never can remember what that is. Okay. So we're getting ready to pump the goo in there. Wouldn't it? You told me your mom and dad, they said, just blow the trumpet. Don't sing. Before when it came to Armstrong. So this is hooked up. Now we're going to pump in about an ounce here. I think I've got about 19 ounces of Freon there. So okay. that ought to be right. So let's just pump this stuff in there. Okay. And you've seen it a million times, so we're just doing it. So your enemy here is air and moisture.
Yes.
And so what you got to do is there's air in this line. So what I like to do is there's a straighter valve right here, and there's a sight glass up here. So you want to run the Freon. I'll hear it go here in just a second. Don't turn the can upside down very much, because that'll blow up your compressor. So this ought to blow out at me. That gets the air out of the line. Okay, so I need both hands. Put the Freon in it. I got the air out of the lines. I can feel the can is cold.
There it goes. The air comes up. It just kicked on. It's cycling on now, so we get Freon in it. Compressor's running longer and longer.
We're probably about 8 ounces, maybe 10 ounces in, and he's announcing it's cooling off. Oh yeah, got a little bit more to go. There it goes. It's just staying on now. That's good.
Yeah. And we're at about 30 pounds on the low side. It's probably 80-something degrees out here.
Where should it be?
It's between 40 and 50-ish.
Okay.
And I don't care about the high side. I mean, I do care, but
everybody should care. But see, I'm getting there. Let it draw it up in there. Let's get the FLIR and see where we ear.
What do we? I don't remember what temperature we did last time. It was
I got mixed down to 28, but you're lucky to get to 30 something.
That'd be awesome.
Yeah. So it's 80 degrees out here, and you just got to take your time with this thing.
So we're down to. We'll pull from the center. It's coming down.
We're only half charge.
Well, we're down to 64. That's pretty good. We're down to in the 50s now.
Gotcha.
And the center vent is the one that you got to read off of.
Okay.
It's silly to ask, but does it have a cabin air filter?
You gotta keep that in mind too. You gotta clean the evaporator and the condenser up here too with some Nu-Brite if you can.
Yeah, we looked at that 98. Hey, some of them even in the 2000s didn't.
I know. I've run into them. Yeah.
Larry's van is a 2000, I think, and it didn't have any.
Okay, we're on our last.
Can I rev it up a little more?
Yeah, in a minute. Okay. We're on our last pan.
Okay. Need more?
No, that's all she's gonna take.
Okay.
That'll be her max. Yeah, go and give her a rev. That's it. Yeah.
So we're down in the 50s. When you drive around, it'll be better. That's pretty good.
49. All right.
I don't know. I don't know anymore. You have to look at it. I haven't bought any more. You want me to replace it, or just go ahead and I'll get extra?
Oh, give me. No, don't give me any money. Give me a case of brake cleaner.
No, I'll get you. I'm going to replace this.
Oh, okay. I need brake clean.
I'll get that too.
Okay. You can get a couple cans if you want to.
All right. Let's see here. Oh, I forgot about that.
So what else?
Case of brake clean. Oh, I need some shock towels. That feels really good. Now we're not driving
yet. So we're gonna do one other little spa treatment here. I'm gonna clean these coils, and that'll knock the temperature down a little bit and knock the head pressure down a little bit. Okay, I think we're about done here. We'll pull it around back. Go ahead.
Can you rev it a little bit?
Yeah. I think that's about all she's going to take.
And so there's our high side up.
That's all she's going to take.
Okay.
And then we'll pull her around. Go ahead and pull her around back where we had her the first time.
All right. And we'll do something else. I always want to do something else, but I want to do something else. What about this? We'll put this on.
Go ahead and put that on, nice and firm. And we'll do a little, another little spa treatment back here. Yeah, we will. Yeah. Just leave the latches off. Okay, so this stuff is diluted. There's your chart right there.
Okay, so it's diluted already?
No, you have to dilute it yourself.
What are you doing?
So you can go 4/6, 8 parts to one.
Which is
4 is the heaviest.
4 is heaviest.
And this stuff's dangerous, guys.
Okay,
so
let's do 8. Right. No, it doesn't have to be real strong, does it?
I'll make the call around here, pal.
All right. Because the vehicle is in good shape. It's not
going to hurt it. It's designed to do what it's going to do.
The coil, it foams on the coil?
Yeah, foam. Gotcha. And we're going to do inside and out. I got the water back there and everything.
Okay.
So we're going to thin this out and spray it down.
Do I need to?
You know what I
mean? Yeah,
spray it from down here.
You can see the dirt. Yeah, there's a dirt dauber there, like
down.
You said. Well, we're gonna hit it all over the place. We're going to hit the condenser and the radiator because everything matters. So right now it looks like this.
But you don't want to get it on the paint, right?
It don't hurt the paint.
It don't?
Nope. At least it's never hurt my paint. But everything I do for you, it goes south generally. I don't know why. I put your damn glasses in the thing and blew them up and everything. And I remember you were saying you're trying to get that rust treatment off your Dodge truck.
Oh, it's horrible.
It's not something that comes off. It changes the rust into a primer.
And then it changes the rust into super pitted and eats through the damn metal.
I know, because you got to keep it painted.
No, we kept it painted.
Oh,
you know, we put all the best paint. We put the
Dodge steel. I'm not going to work on Dodges anymore.
Yeah.
Well, there's your problem, lady. Look at the dirt coming out of there.
Yeah, that'll help.
Yeah. It's a fountain of Nu-Brite.
Now, do you do it from the back side?
Yeah, I was getting ready to do the back
side. Oh, it's already coming out through there.
Well, we're going to do it anyway. We're going to give this a couple of treatments.
All right.
Because that is incredible. Okay, that's
well, 1998. It's probably never been done other than just washed.
Okay, let's do the backside. Wow, that's amazing. We've determined that Extend does not work well with Chrysler steel, because you know.
Well,
anyway,
we probably didn't do it right, or I didn't do it.
Oh, that's right. It's all the dirt just pouring out of there, and oh, look what messed up your paint. Be sure and hit it on the inside. Don't get any water. On any of the components.
All right.
Because it's a Jeep thing.
It's a hot engine thing, right?
And if you use, the water's heated because the hose has been in the sun, but if you got to use cold water, like Sean was saying, just use it sparingly and just don't shock it into submission. I've created a Nu-Brite monster. Now, if you do, you know, bring all your vehicles up here and we'll do all of this. Look at it foaming again.
That's
is that mud dauber nest gone?
No, it's not. I was going to take a little stick and knock it down, but that's all right.
Wait a minute. I got some. I got a little plastic scraper. I'd rather use that. It's still foaming up, so I wouldn't go more than 2 treatments on this.
No, it's pretty clean. I don't see much dirt.
Yeah. Yeah, there's still some in there. But this will be more than good enough.
Yeah.
Now, if it springs a leak on the way home, it ain't my fault, okay? Like you just said, it's old 98. The wreck of the old 98.
Well, whoever had it before me took real good care of it, that's for sure.
Okay. Okay, that's the last rinse, and we'll go do a test drive here in a few minutes and see what we get coming out of the vents. That's the closing song to Dr. Strangelove, or How I Learned to Stop Worrying and Love the Bomb. Vera Lynn, I think, is her name. Very good. We'll meet again some sunny day. Okay, Let's go for a ride. Did you get that mud dauber nest out of there?
Yeah.
Okay.
Air compressor.
I'll turn the air off. That ain't helping any. Well, it just got the belt wet.
Yeah. Slicked it. Come on, you man. I know how to fix that. So.
Go back and put some belt pressing on it.
No, I know. I know what it
there
takes.
Goes. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. All right, we're on the road here. It's okay.
On the road again.
That's better, isn't it?
Oh my golly. Oh my golly. That feels good.
Yeah, that does feel good. We're in the 50s, 60s. But it is like 85 degrees outside. This thing's pretty tight, yeah. 50 degrees is pretty good. If you find that it's not really doing good for you.
30-something degrees cooler than here and then out there.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's about all you can ask for.
I'm satisfied with that.
That's generally the rule, 30 to 40 degrees different from outside.
32 would be refrigeration.
Yeah, we're in the 40s now.
And the temperature gauge is down where it's not normally. It runs a little bit above that a quarter. So it's actually running cooler.
We've got the radiator clean.
Yeah, made a difference.
Just turn around and go back.
Probably about 3 or 4 degrees difference, maybe.
Yeah, that. You're just able to disperse the heat. There was a big wreck here the other day.
Was there?
Did they knock down the railroad thing?
I see that, yeah.
They knocked that whole arm down. The whole thing was in the road, and there's an emergency vehicle there. Wait a minute.
Johnny Law Dog, I mean.
Well, we're going in.
Good, buddy.
Where are you going?
Here we go.
He's enjoying that, isn't he?
Yeah. Them guys love that stuff.
They do. I know.
They get addicted to it.
They sure do.
All right. Let's go follow him.
No, let's go back to the house. All right. Well, just see how long it lasts. If you feel like it's warming up on you, we'll put another couple ounces in it. But I think I just saw 38 flash up.
This feels good, man.
Yeah, 34.
No kidding.
Yeah.
Are you serious?
Yeah. I got it on tape.
Well, hang some meat in this thing.
Yeah, we're dancing down in the 30s now.
Yeah, that temperature gauge, man, that made a difference on the cooling because it usually runs a little bit above the 200 mark, and now it's down around the 190.
That's gonna help you out a lot.
Yeah, all right.
Well, give me a thumbs up.
Let go.
All right.
Thanks, Bob.
Yeah, man.
Bob's AC service does it again.
Yeah, $500 a visit. If I do anything or not.
That's it.
This is really quite pleasant.
It is, man. This is actually as cool, as cold as the Sebring is, man.
I tell you the truth, I think that Ester really helps.
Yeah. Yeah, that cocktail you make works like a charm.
Yeah,
a little deviate from that.
Yeah, that does good. It's got oil in it and everything. So I'm real happy with that. They chopped down the wheat, but it just don't seem like they did much. Yeah, there's no snacks. Okay, the only snack I got is I want you to see. I blocked this off with the Edelbrock cover. Now hop on up in there and tell me what you think.
I like that.
So it's all been cleaned and rust treated. like that. It works because it was up under there.
Yeah.
And it went. And you couldn't get it to work.
Right.
This way you only got one turn.
Got it.
It had three turns.
Ah.
And so I moved it there.
So it works.
Oh yeah, it works.
Gotcha.
So I got the cow seats and. Pull that back and get, that's why I did that, so we can pull it back and get it out of the way.
Okay,
see the new fuel gauge? So you got a new fuel gauge.
Oh, right there, yeah.
And it really, really works.
Nice, and it works this time, huh? Yeah. There's your fuel, there's your shut off.
I put a new, I don't think the battery's connected, nah. But it does work, it's on video if you want to see it.
It's cool, man.
But yeah, I got the new throttle cable.
You haven't put the new shifter in though yet.
That's all done.
It's all done.
Yeah, that's the way. I just don't have the cover on it.
So it shifts okay, like.
Yeah, try the brakes. See, the brakes are good too.
Oh baby, damn.
And I'm not through adjusting them yet.
It's all right. And the AC works.
AC
on
works
it?
Good. And
nice.
You can hold on to that for a second. It's on. So.
Yeah, the lock clock's working. The lock clock. Yeah, the clock's working and all that.
Yeah, the clock is running.
Clock is running. Now what? It's okay to fire it up?
No, it's not okay. We're not gonna fire it up.
Oh yeah.
I just wanted you to see you turn this on, and you got all your dash lights.
Check that out, man.
And then there's your gas gauge working.
Yeah.
And see, look behind you.
Yeah.
So everything's going.
Yeah.
Fuel gauge works, everything. So hop on. Oh, wait a minute. Now, see what the. No, don't turn that off quite yet. See, this light right here is my brake warning light.
Okay.
So if the front or the back goes bad, it'll give me a warning light. And it came on one time because the linings came off the brake shoes. The light came on, told me.
Cool.
I backed up and it'd lock up.
And that's your dimmer switch.
Mm-hmm. Isn't that cool?
Yeah.
Hop on out.
I like that.
And I'll. Yeah, don't get hooked on that thing. Now, check out them cab lights. Now, they come on with the key.
Oh, yeah. <That's laughs>
they come on. And so those are like daylight runners.
Yeah.
So I thought that was pretty cool.
Yeah.
All right.
I like those.
Oh, come on. Turn the battery off. All right. Oh, and I built new sun visors. Yeah, I was thinking about that. I built me some new sun visors, and so those are real nice.
Yeah.
The other ones were just kind of moldy and rotten.
Yeah.
But I got all the mold. I got all the black mold out of it, which is good.
Yeah.
And.
That's good, man. You got you some LEDs on the back there.
Yeah, all the lights are LEDs now.